Do you have any appreciation of their, in a sense, feeling that NATO membership that goes to Georgia and Ukraine is just too close to their borders to make them comfortable?
Look, I think the biggest problem with this kind of their reactions is much wider than that. I think what is much more alarming for them now, it's not, you know, just, you know, formal installation of NATO's flag next to their borders. They are already used to it. They have it in other places, and they're, you know, they're fine with it. The problem there is that, you know, this small Georgia, which they thought was, you know, decapitated, they called me political corpse in the aftermath of the 2008 invasion. They gave me just a few weeks to survive, maybe, you know, but they also thought that Georgia would never recover. And now they see that people from all around, from Kyrgyzstan, the other day President Otarbayeva spoke at length about learning from Georgia, Ukraine, Moldova, government ministers, heads of governments, you know, presidents in our region, Armenia, Azerbaijan. These people are talking a lot about learning from Georgia reform, and indeed lots of Russians, including some government officials, saying, look at this country, if they could make
it. So your point is?
I think this is in some way almost ideological, that the way how we managed to tackle corruption, the way how we managed to free up business and to live with free speech, kind of country where, you know, in this post-Soviet.
So they're worried, in your judgment, that what you do will infect.
They think it's contagious, because until now they believed that there were only two kind of regimes in former Soviet states. Yeltsin kind of chaos, when, you know, everybody went to mass and it was kind of democracy, but, you know, totally chaotic, or Putin type of authoritarian stability. And now we said they suddenly see a country that's building democracy at a gunpoint, succeeding. This year already might have even double digits growth. At least first month we had 9.6 or 7, and that's the year's trend. It's getting
For 2011, the trend is 9.6.
January's trend was 9.7.
That was for the month of January.
But for the whole year, actually.
Growth in
projected growth for the year.
9 point.
Yeah, and
so therefore that makes you a. That's the Singapore part of your dream.
No, actually, and they are seeing visuals already. It's not only that, but they see that, you know, we have country that has given laptops to kids at school. We invited 10,000 English teachers, Americans, to teach English. We are building new American-based, you know, universities, inviting American universities, building new technological campuses. There are amazing new roads, new cities, and the country is coming back. It's not only just what is on the paper, but it's the reality. The reality is that, and this country still has freedom of speech. What is We are not flawless. We have lots of problems. We have lots of obstacles. But, you know, sometimes it's almost funny. It reminds me how we used to treat when I was a child, a kid, the Cold War's America. It was perfect for us. It was an absolute ideal. No criticism was accepted. You know, in Russia, obviously, press is under control and they vilify us. But there is a small segment of, you know, social networks, small newspapers they have that are still more or less independent, and they absolutely are idyllic about Georgia. Georgia is perfect. And sometimes from our point of view, when regular Georgian, you know, folks read it, they are irritated by both. You know, on the one hand, we are not as bad as the official media, right. But on the other, we cannot be this good because we live in our country. We know we have problems.
All right, let me just talk about some
other things. I think that's the major problem, not just NATO membership there.
Join us online at charlierose.com.